is subject to recording and monitoring. Press 1 or star to accept the call. To deny this call, press 2. Thank you for using Cellmate.
Hello?
Hey, how's it going, sir?
Hi, this is Tom.
Yeah, this is Tom from Community TV. I guess one of your friends said that I should somehow get in touch with you because you're in the remand center and there's something going on.
Yeah, so they started locking us up. They put us on a tier. Like, we're usually out all day. The unit that I've been on, there hasn't been one code, not one situation in 4 months that I've been here. And so they come today and they say, oh, we're on tier program, which means we're an hour and 15, locked up, the other tiers out for an hour or whatever. And the reason for that is overcrowding, which is, I don't really think is right. It's a prison. It's not overcrowded. There is people triple bunked, but there's people triple bunked in every other jail in Alberta. They get assaulted, they get jumped, they get stabbed, that happens, and then the guards say, oh, well, how does this happen? Like, this is your guys' fault. Like, well, no, it's not our fault. You guys are prison guards. You're supposed to guard us, but you guys are stuck on social media, looking up people's Facebook, convicts. And, like, the food we're fed, for instance, the fish puck. Fish cake. They stay right on the box for not for human consumption, for inmates only.
Ooh, that's kind of weird. So, what they're saying is that basically the guards and the remand center themselves are saying that because of the overcrowding issue, they have to keep you on lockdown all the time.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
No, sorry, go on, sorry.
So if you're on lockdown and, you know, you don't have so much as any freedom to move around or you know, be outside of the cell, I guess. And then so what I heard from somebody that told me to get in touch with you is that they're doing a hunger strike because of this. Like, you're going to refuse the food?
That's right, yeah.
And so is everybody in the remand center in agreement with this, or are there, like, factions, or?
It's one unit for now.
Yeah.
Because it just started, the other units don't know, we don't get to talk to them or anything.
And how many people are in a unit?
There's 17 on this unit.
Yeah.
Which is, it's overcrowded now, but they're still putting people on the floors or whatever, right? Not one fight on this specific unit in the 4 months I've been here, not one issue. And the other unit, people have checked off of that unit due to a fight club. There's codes every other day, and their capacity over on the other units have been 17 more than we were on this unit, and they weren't put on pilot.
And I gotta imagine that even if all the guys are decent guys and you're not fighting, it's still got to be pretty hard to convince 17 guys in the remand center not to eat.
Oh yeah.
So this is pretty serious.
System. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of us out now, okay?
Yeah.
So we get out an hour and 15 minutes, and there's 2 phones.
Okay, and so you probably had to make some deals to get a hold of the phone, and then not only that, you're spending the freedom time that you have trying to contact the media, so this is pretty serious.
That's right. And, we have access to the phone.
Yeah.
But, like I said, there's people, sorry, 9 of us, everybody uses the phone to call their family, right?
Yeah.
As opposed to when we're a normal day, everybody's out all day. There's a count time from 11:30 to 1 and then 5 to 7 that we're locked up normally. But we're out all day, so everybody gets the equal amount to try the phone. But now, it's just, it's more stressful. It causes more ruckus now that we're locked up. Shower times, now we have to make a point and go on a hunger strike just to get something across to these guys. Like, this is not, like, the answer. Like, this is, like...
Yeah.
Why are you doing this? Because it's over capacity. That doesn't make any sense. Other jails, for instance, I did 11 months in Calgary. Calgary Remand Center, and it's a 22-hour lockdown there, and there's 144 guys there, an open bubble, so the dark, dark behind glass like they are here, and there's four zones, and each zone gets out a half an hour in the afternoon and then an hour and a half at night, and that's just Calgary Remand because there's so many guys, granted, right?
Yeah.
And there's 46 guys on a unit on one zone, and they're out for half an hour or an hour and 15 minutes at a time. 46 guys and only two guards.
So what you're saying is you've seen other places where the capacity is way higher and there's
it just doesn't happen.
And it just still doesn't happen. Okay, so what are the big things like you miss out on when this lockdown happens? I guess you mentioned the phone. What else are people missing out on?
Right now the new schedule came. Hold on. Hold on. Sorry, people are yelling at me.
Yeah, man, if you can't stay too long, I understand. I don't want to get you in any kind of trouble.
Yeah, no, that's fine. We have to lock up here in 2 minutes, but there'll be somebody else calling you. I'm going to pass your number off.
Yeah.
And then they'll tell you their story. Maybe they're better talkers than I am.
Yeah.
But
no, that's okay, man. You're telling me exactly what's going on in there, and that's great.
That's it.
Yeah.
Something needs to happen. Like, everybody knows, yeah, the conservatives have been in for 44 years, and they wanted, like three strikes, like, you know, like, and we're in a remand center, and we're innocent until proven guilty, supposedly. But actually, in Alberta, we are guilty until proven innocent.
Like, right, so... When you're missing out on phone calls and stuff like that, and phone time, I guess a lot of you guys could be missing out on phone calls with your lawyers, or...
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Like, see, the guard just banged on the window right now. Like, I have to lock up. Like, I'm going to have to let you go, but I'm gonna pass your number off to somebody else.
Okay, do you want to... I'll just use the conversation that we had without your name in there, and if anybody else wants to call me, that's totally cool. I'm here for him.
Okay, thanks, Tom, so very much.
Yeah, I wish you success, man.
Thank you, thanks, and I'll get this guy to call you.
All right, we'll talk to you later.
Okay, see you, Tom, thanks, bye.
Later. Wow. Okay, so that right there was an inmate spending his free time to give me a call, and it was just kind of an emergency pullover on the side of the road. I actually have a tire going flat in my truck right now, and I need to get down to a gas station so that I can pump it up. But I got the call, and I knew it was from the remand center because of the phone number. Answered it, got things going, and you can hear at the start of the recording, there's a little voice there that says, you know, like, thank you for doing the call from... whatever it is, the special system for inmate phones, but yeah, so there's something going on at the remand center right now, and I guess inmates are quite upset about an issue that they say, I mean, the media is saying overcrowding, but I guess it sounded like that inmate was saying everything's overcrowded. That's not really the issue. The issue is that they're not given any free time outside, or they're very, very limited, and that's not allowing them access to phone calls. Many of these people are totally innocent. You know, they have to go through the court system still, and they need to talk to their lawyers, need to talk to their families and all that kind of thing. So, yeah, it sounds like there's going to be a hunger strike at the remand center that's already started in one of the units. And, you know, we'll see how this goes. Keep you up to date. Thanks for watching Community TV.